Speed Wallet is a mobile Bitcoin wallet where simplicity is the name of the game. You can set up an account in minutes and be sending and receiving Bitcoin in no time at all. And they've also baked in convenient ways to shop and use your Bitcoin, as well as a reward system too. Today, we're going to be taking a look at how to set up and use Speed Wallet for mobile. I am Ben with the BTC Sessions. This is your daily session.
HODL the Bitcoin.
Bitcoin Well is on a mission to enable independence by being one of the easiest and quickest ways to purchase Bitcoin in Canada and the US. And the best part about it, every buy goes directly into your own self-custody. They never hold your coins. You can add a Bitcoin address as part of onboarding. There's a transparent 1% spread, no hidden fees, no withdrawal fees. Plus, they have KYC-free sells and bill payments on their website. They're also a publicly traded company under the ticker BTCW on the TSXV. Check them out over at bitcoinwell.com. Check out my full tutorial on how to use them. And you can check out the links in the show notes down below and sign up today. onchain.com has some of the best hardware on the market today to secure your Bitcoin. The Cold Card Q is an absolute powerhouse and is my daily driver. And on top of this, they have plenty of other goodies, including the Mark IV, the Tap Signer, Open Dimes, the Block Clock, and much more. If you head over to their website, make sure you use code BTC Sessions at checkout to get a nice discount. Links are in the show notes down below. So let's start with prerequisites. What are you going to need to know in order to successfully navigate this tutorial? Well, we're going to be starting from the basis of pretty much scratch. The one thing that you're going to need to be familiar with based on where you're located is how to obtain Bitcoin, because you can't buy Bitcoin from within Speed Wallet, although who knows, maybe that feature will be added later. Either way, this is meant to be your spending day-to-day wallet. You can receive Bitcoin into it and then you can spend it out or spend it within the app on things like gift cards. So we're going to walk through again all the basic setup, everything like that. If you have some experience with sending and receiving Bitcoin payments, either what's known as on-chain or via the Lightning Network, that's an asset, but we'll walk through how to do that in the tutorial as well. I will also give a demo of how to withdraw from an exchange. If you're sitting on an exchange and have funds there and want to pull it into Speed Wallet, I'll show you how that would work as well. Other than that, I will be kind of showing payments going from wallet to wallet, from Speed Wallet to other wallets and back the other way. And any of the wallets that I do mention will also be linked with full tutorials in the show notes as well. Other than that, if you do have other questions, please drop them into the comments down below and feel free to peruse throughout the channel, because I do have a ton of tutorials and other stuff. But with that, I'll just quickly show you here. This is the website speed.app, and that will have links to both Google Play and the Apple App Store. It's available on both platforms, and you can also add it as a plugin for your Chrome browser, and we'll get into that towards the end, but you'll be able to see it on both your phone and your desktop computer either way. So with that, let's dive onto the phone and we'll take a look at a freshly installed Speed Wallet. All right, so here I am on my phone with a fresh install of Speed Wallet. And just for reference, this is an Android phone, but it would be much the same across iPhone with maybe a few slight variations. Either way, let's go ahead. We're going to hit get started. And so it gives us a couple intro screens letting us know what to expect. So we can send, receive, make fast transactions via on-chain or Lightning Network. We can shop with gift cards, and we can earn Bitcoin as we utilize the wallet. So I'm going to hit finish in the top right, and here we go. So this is a custodial Lightning wallet, meaning that you are trusting Speed Wallet with the funds therein. Now, everybody has their own preferences when it comes to custody. And so if you're a staunch self-custody advocate, then, you know, this may not pertain to you. However, the focus here again is on usability and simplicity. And so pretty much with these guys, you can sign up and out the gate, start making transactions and have a Lightning address, which is just an ability to receive Bitcoin transactions with something that looks like an email address. And they do it with a sign up via your either Google account or just simply with email. So again, you can sign in here just with easy clicks. And then down below, if you need a new account, there's a sign up button. And so when you hit that, it'll shift. And then again, it'll say sign up with Google or sign up with email. And so it's pretty simple. Once you hit the sign up with Google, it will bring up any Google accounts that you have associated. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to click on. Now, I do have an existing one. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to sign up with my other account. And then we'll jump to my other main phone so that we can see my existing account with all its settings and everything. And we can start to play with that one. So either way, I'm going to click on my other email account here. And it says, do you want to use this? By continuing, Google will share your name, email address, profile picture with Speed Wallet. I'm going to hit continue. And then it will begin to sign me in. And then it's going to ask me just country, and that's pretty much it. So I am in Canada. I'm going to hit submit. And then do I want notifications? I'll say allow there. And that's it, my friends. Pretty much I'm all set up. There's one additional thing that I want to do. And down below it says create Speed Lightning address. And so when I hit setup, it says this will generate a Lightning Network address using your desired username to accept payment. One-time creation of the LN address, it can't be updated or deleted, okay? So make sure whatever you put in here is something that you want to use. So I'm going to hit setup, and then you will simply type in a username here. So I'll just do the same as my email address that I used before. Okay, so there we go. And again, this is the kind of the demo setup here, but we'll jump to my regular one afterwards. So I'm going to hit save. And then it says you've successfully claimed your Lightning address. Your Lightning address is as follows, exactly what I typed in, benperrin117@speed.app. Again, maybe don't utilize that because I have a BTC sessions at speed.app on the other one that I've already set up. But I'll go ahead, I'll hit close. And there we go. So wallet is now all set up. If I were to go onto another phone, then I could log in simply with my Google account, or if I had done it with email, it would be email and password. But either way, this is all set up, and I'm gonna jump to my other phone with my BTC Sessions account, and we'll start getting a lay of the land and what's in front of us. Okay, so here we are on my actual regular phone with my real account here on Speed Wallet. And as you'll notice, the interface looks a little bit different. It's in dark mode because my phone is set as such, and it just kind of took those default settings there. So a little bit of a different look, but nonetheless, everything is all in front of us. So let's get a lay of the land and see what is in this app. So here on the home screen, what you'll notice is down along the bottom, there are four tabs. There's wallet, history, shop, and rewards. So we are currently on the wallet screen. And so there, what you'll have is in the center, a balance. The balance is in sats, but then down below, you'll see how much those sats are worth. Now, if you're new to Bitcoin and you're unfamiliar, sats, what are those? In a Bitcoin, there are 100 million sats. You can think of them like the pennies to Bitcoin's dollar, but there are far more pennies in a Bitcoin. Okay, so we have a few thousand sats sitting here in the wallet, and then underneath, there's a dollar value. Now, you get to set your local currency or what it will show as underneath in the settings. So I have mine actually set to US dollar value because that's tends to be what I deal with a lot. But if I wanted to, I could have it show the Canadian dollar equivalent. But nonetheless, that is all in front of me here. Up top, I have two tabs as well. One for BTC or Bitcoin, and the other for USDT, which is a US dollar stable coin. Now, I tend to not deal with stable coins a lot, but it is useful for people to have for those maybe in jurisdictions where they don't have access to stable dollar values. That's an option for them. So nonetheless, if you wanted to be dealing with that, you would tap on the USDT tab and you'd have the same thing send and receive down below. So as I alluded to down below, I have my my Lightning address here, BTC sessions at speed.app, and that's the one that I actually use. And there's an easy copy button beside it so that I can paste it into messages or whatever I need. Anybody with that information can send me money. I also, as I said, have receive and send buttons. When I hit receive, it will bring up my Lightning invoice, which I can add a value to by hitting the button down below if I want to specify an invoice amount. And then there's also a Bitcoin tab, and that is for on-chain transactions, which are a little bit slower, a little bit more expensive to deal with. But if you're coming out of an exchange, perhaps to fund a wallet, that can be quite useful because not all exchanges support Lightning Network yet. Lightning Network being cheaper and faster to use. So nonetheless, we have our receive screen there, and we'll get into the details of using this momentarily. And then from the send screen, when I hit send, the first time you open that, it will ask you to approve the camera. You can see the camera is indeed working, but it's just blanked out there. So it will by default open up the camera so that you could scan a QR code in front of you if you were paying somebody in person. Or you can paste something copied from the clipboard, which would be like somebody's Lightning address or a Lightning invoice, or you can tap and you can type out manually something here. So again, I can paste in, you know, a Lightning address that was in my clipboard there. But nonetheless, that's your send screen. And I'll X out of that and get back to the main screen. We also have in the top right, a settings. And so this is where, again, you can see a number of different things. They do have chat support, which is great. You can set your local currency. You can see mine's currently set to USD, as I said. You have your profile. So things like having my little avatar, my picture there, name and all that, if I choose to put those in. Again, some security things, two-step verification. So if you want to, you can activate two-step verification, and that gives an extra layer of security, so that you know, in order to spend, it requires, or rather, to log in on another device, it requires an extra verification. You can turn on biometrics if you like, so whether that be face or thumbprint or whatever, and then you can also change your password. Then there's just some basic stuff. It plays a little ding every time you receive a payment or you send a payment, haptic feedback, the little buzz every time you tap the buttons and all that. Again, chat support, there's a Telegram group. And yeah, that's more or less it here on the main screen. We'll get into the reward stuff after the fact. Okay, and now let's navigate down to the bottom of the screen and let's just take a peek around. If I click on history, there's a history of previous transactions in and out of the wallet. Again, initially when you set up, that will not be present because you won't have transactions yet. In the top right, if I tap, then I can filter out transactions based on criteria if I want to. Okay, I can go to shop, and this has a plugin for BitRefill where you can get all kinds of different gift cards depending on your locale. And we will test that out momentarily as well. So I'll just go back here. And then down in the bottom right again, if I go to rewards, this is where we can earn some Bitcoin as we utilize the wallet. You know, small amounts that can build up over time just by using the wallet. So we will go through now using all of this now that we have a good lay of the land and understand where everything is located. All right, so first up, I am going to fund this wallet as if I had not already played with Lightning before, and I was coming from an exchange, and I just needed to withdraw and get it into my spending wallet here. So how would I go about doing that? Well, first things first, in Speed Wallet, I'm going to go down and I'm going to hit receive. And some exchanges will support Lightning withdrawals, at which point you may be giving them your Speed address, that BTC sessions at speed.app. And just to show again right here on the main screen, copying that. That may be as simple as what they require. You may also be required to create an invoice, which on the main screen you would add the amount that they designated you need to request. But some exchanges may not have Lightning withdrawals. So how would you fund this wallet from an online exchange that doesn't have Lightning currently? Well, really simple. I'm going to tap on Bitcoin. This gives me a Bitcoin address, okay? A regular Bitcoin address. I'm going to hit the copy button there, and that copies this string of digits. That is all that I need. And so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to navigate out here, and I'm going to go to an exchange. This exchange is called Bitcoin Well. And so I use them here in Canada, and they're also available in the US. So I'm going to tap on that and open it up. I already have it pulled up to a screen because it's going to vary depending on the exchange that you're using. But again, all I need to do is provide the address that I've copied from Speed Wallet. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to paste that in. And I did make a mental note of the first few digits and the last few digits, and I'm seeing that they're the same. So I know that I'm adding, you know, I'm not pasting in something incorrectly. Okay, so I'm basically just adding this address so Bitcoin Well is aware of it. I'm going to hit add. And there we go. It is now added as my receiving address here. And so with Bitcoin Well, they have various ways of purchasing, but the way it works with this particular exchange is the moment you send the money, once they receive it through a bank transfer, which I'm going to do, then they will send out the Bitcoin to your designated address. So I'm going to be doing something called Interact e-transfer, which is something native to Canada. In the US, you have some other different options there. But nonetheless, I'm going to be doing that. And so I'm just going to go ahead. I'm going to send off a transaction. You basically can get a price for how much you're going to be buying. But again, if I was doing like $100 or $200, I would see that here and it would let me know how much Bitcoin to expect. Okay. So nonetheless, I'm going to shoot off a quick transfer here from my bank account. And then in very short order, I should be sent Bitcoin into my Speed wallet and we'll see it pop up and then we'll go from there. Okay, so here we are back in Speed Wallet and I'm on my main wallet screen. And if you'll notice, yes, I still have the same balance up top, but there's a little notification down below it that says plus 238,000 some odd sats. And if we tap on that, we can see that it is under pending transactions. I can even tap on the transaction itself and see further details. And I see that I have around $143 US dollars coming into this account, which is worth, again, 238,000 some odd sats. And it says pending. And so the reason it's pending is because that was a regular Bitcoin. It's known as an on-chain transaction, not a Lightning transaction, not the quick, cheap ones, but this one takes a little bit longer to finally settle and it's a little bit more expensive to send. Although what I'll say is with Bitcoin Well, you can opt into the free withdrawals and they do withdrawals once a day. I opted to do a quicker withdrawal this time around, but nonetheless, it has it has been sent to my Speed wallet. And so as soon as the network confirms that transaction and it settles, then I will have it available as part of my main balance here. And this little notification with the hourglass will go away and all of that will be allocated up top. And then I'll be able to spend it as regular Lightning
transactions. So I can send to other Bitcoin Lightning wallets or to other speed users or whatever it may be, that will all be accessible here. So we'll just wait for that to confirm. And then we will try receiving in a couple other ways before we dive into spending. And here we are some time later, and you can see that we now have all of our balance allocated up top, and the hourglass notification down below has been replaced with my most recent confirmed transaction, which is that exact amount coming in. If I go to history, again, we can see that most recent transaction up top as completed. So that is all done. And I will say that if you are receiving a transaction from somebody that doesn't have a Lightning capable wallet, then again, it is just as simple as hitting receive and then tapping on the Bitcoin tab, and you'll have a Bitcoin address that somebody can scan right there. Otherwise, if they are capable of using Lightning, then stay over there on the Lightning tab, and that will keep you with cheap, quick transactions. And with that said, let's dive into actually receiving Lightning transactions to your wallet in a couple of different ways. All right, so now we're diving into the Lightning transaction part of this receive portion. And so what we're going to do is we're going to go again down to the bottom left and hit receive. And by default, this will bring up what's known as a Lightning invoice. So you're asking somebody to send you some amount of Bitcoin, and we won't designate any specific amount for this. And this will work for a number of Lightning addresses that people can interact with, and then it will then prompt them to input their own amount. So I'm just going to use an example here. So I've got a secondary wallet up, and I'm just going to hit send. And this is not Speed Wallet, this is a totally different one, but just to show as an example, I can scan and it starts as 0 sats as the amount, but then I can type in whatever I prefer. So let's send 100 sats and hit send there, and off it should go. So I can see it sent out of the one wallet, and then we get the notification. I love that sound on Speed when you receive. And so there we go, 100 sats into my wallet, and it shows my most recent transaction there underneath. And again, if I go to history, there it is up top, added to my balance. Perfect. Okay, so we can also designate a specific amount by creating an invoice. So if I hit receive again, then down at the bottom, there's an option that says add amount slash note. So if I hit that, then I can designate a dollar amount by typing in, you know, a number of dollars I'd like to receive, and it will automatically interpret how many sats that is. Alternatively, if I hit the two little arrows in the middle, it allows me to put a number of sats up top and type that in. Maybe I'll change the amount so we can see it, differentiate it from the previous transaction. I can also add a note if I like, so I can label it whatever I want. I'll just call it test for now, but typically you would type where did this money come from, and this is more for your own records so that you remember what you were doing. So I've created an invoice, or I'm about to create an invoice for 150 sats. I just labeled it as test. I'll hit submit, and that's going to again generate a QR code, but this QR code has the amount encoded into it. So in the demo wallet again, if I hit send and I scan that, then it auto sees, oh, this is for 150 sats. That's what's being requested. I can hit send, and once again, off it goes, and there's our notification coming in to Speed Wallet. So that is a relatively simple way of doing it. Now, if somebody was not in front of you and not able to scan your QR code, once again, what you could do is, whether or not you input an actual amount, down below there's a string of digits and you could simply hit copy. It will copy it to your clipboard, and you can message that string to anybody and it will act the same when they paste it into their own wallet. So again, you don't need to be right with somebody. You can just simply copy and paste the text and send it off. And there's even a little share option or copy option so that you can share it in multiple places. So there you have it with Lightning invoices. Now there's one other way to receive, and that is with your Lightning address. And all anybody needs is that Lightning address if they have a designated wallet that deals with that. So once again, in a demo wallet, I'm going to hit send, but this time I'm not going to scan anything. I'm actually going to type in this information here, BTC sessions at speed.app. So I'm going to type that in now. Okay, so I've got that added in. I'm going to go to the next screen. And again, it'll default to a small amount, in this case, one sat, but maybe I'll change it to 55 sats, just as an example. Okay, so I've got that queued up. It should be going to this payment address. It even denotes, oh, this is a speed payment address. I'm going to hit send. And off it goes. And I can it my phone closed before I could get the fun little receive notification. But nonetheless, I see 55 sats coming into the wallet there. And if I go to history again, there's the transaction up top. So multiple ways to receive. And just as a recap, those are via Lightning, an invoice without an amount attached, an invoice with an amount by hitting add amount, or directly to your own Lightning address. Alternatively, if you need to receive on-chain, just choose Bitcoin and anybody can scan that, or you can copy the address and paste it and send it to somebody and they'll be able to send you Bitcoin as well. Okay, so let's get into sending funds from Speed Wallet. Now I've got both phones up here. This is the initial one that we set up just as a test. And this is the one we've been using because you can see the balance here. So let's say that I wanted to send to a new user or to somebody that has a Lightning invoice. Again, different ways to do it. So let's go and hit receive on the test wallet and we'll create an invoice for this one for 100 sats. And so we've got a QR code now that we can scan. So on my wallet that I want to send from, I can hit send. That'll open up my camera, a quick scan, and it detects 100 sats, and I send, and off it shall go. There we go, and on both. So there we go, sent and received between the wallets. Now I wanna show the act of pasting in an invoice. So I'm gonna create an invoice here, let's say for 99 sats. Okay, so somebody has created an invoice and they want me to send them money, but I'm not with them. So they're instead going to hit copy down below. They're going to send this string of text off to me so that I can paste it into my wallet. So I'm going to do that right now. I'm just sending it to myself via a Messenger app. And I will copy that information from my Messenger app on the other phone. Okay, so I've now copied it into my clipboard. When I tap, it will automatically detect there's something in my clipboard. So I can go ahead and I can just hit proceed here. Alternatively, I could go to the send screen and then I could paste it in after the fact, but I like that it pulls up the clipboard data and knows right away that I want to send. So I'm just going to hit proceed. If I didn't want to be sending from the wallet for this, I would just hit discard, but I'll hit proceed. It shows me the invoice for 99 sats and send, and off it goes. Perfect. Okay. So really simple to paste in an invoice. And then finally, again, sending, I can go hit send. And then I have the option, as I said, to paste in or type in information. And that is at the bottom of the send screen. So you can see, if I wanted to paste in an invoice, there's a paste option there. Conveniently, actually, if I had a QR code, I could actually upload the QR code if I had saved it as an image on my computer or on my phone. And then finally, as I said, down below, I have the opportunity to type. So let's type in the address for this wallet here. So that was BenPerrin117, not at Gmail, but at speed.app. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and hit send. I'll type in an amount, let's say 45 sats, and I will just now hit send, and off it goes. and then a little bit more silently on the other phone there. But nonetheless, we see 45 sats going in, and our most recent transaction here shows us 45 sats going out. Going to the history, we can see all the transactions we've been doing. So we have been able to send multiple ways, but there is one other way, and I'm not going to actually send this way because, again, as we've seen, regular Bitcoin transactions have slightly higher fees and they're a little bit slower, but we can still see how to do it without having to get hit with. And this is, by the way, it's not a speed wallet fee. It is a network fee that is inherent to the Bitcoin network. So on the demo wallet, I'm just going to hit receive and I'm going to go to Bitcoin. And then on my actual wallet, I'm going to hit send. Now, I don't need to do anything special when I'm sending in terms of switching between Lightning and Bitcoin. When you're receiving, you need to designate. But when you're sending, this wallet will just figure it out based on the information you give it. So I'm just going to scan this QR code. And it says, oh, okay, so you want to send via on-chain. How much would you like to send? And let's designate a dollar amount here. So let's say I wanted to send $100. Okay. And then it lets me know down below all of the details of this transaction. Okay. So you're sending this amount. The speed fee is zero. There's no fee from speed. The network fee, however, is just under a dollar. It's around 81 cents. And what I'll say is the Bitcoin network is very dependent on how busy is it and how much data does your transaction require. It has nothing to do with the amount that you're sending. So don't get it confused. It's not like a percentage fee. No, it's based on the amount of data and how many other people are currently transacting. And that can impact your fees. So certain types of transactions on chain may not be economically viable. It may not make sense, especially if it's super busy at that moment. That's why it's best to rely on Lightning instead. But you can still do that. You just have to be cognizant of the fee when you're here. And then you would just hit send and off it would go. I'm not going to do that right now because I have no need to send out $100, but I just wanted to show. And you can also see how it would make sense for me to send like a dollar this way, right? Most of it would be eaten up by fees. So just so you're aware, you can send on-chain transactions. As we saw, we could also receive. And just be cautious when you do so that you're not spending tiny amounts this way. It's best to be sending, I'd say, at least a few hundred dollars this way to keep it economically viable. Otherwise, defer to Lightning. That's your best bet.
Debify.com allows you to borrow against your Bitcoin in a non-custodial way. Collateral is held in a 3 of 4 distributed multisig with trusted parties. It provides institutional liquidity providers, loan periods of up to 5 years with flexible conditions and the best rates. And best of all, no rehypothecation of your funds. If you want to check them out today, head over to debify.com or hit the link in the show notes down below.
All right, now one of the cool things about Speed Wallet is that they've integrated easy ways to utilize your Bitcoin when it's sitting in the wallet. And so the shop tab down at the bottom takes you to a plugin that is BitRefill. Now, I'm a huge fan of BitRefill. I use them all the time. I buy my groceries with them. I use them for gas. I use them for a whole bunch of other stuff. And so I'm going to demo how you can do this from within the app. So when you hit the shop tab, you're presented with lots of different options in your area. Your location will be designated up top, but if for some reason it's showing incorrectly, just tap on the little flag and then do the drop down to choose the correct company, the correct country, and it will show relevant gift cards to you. And so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to get an Amazon gift card. So I'm going to tap here. And then it allows me to choose the amount that I would like to purchase. And there's a drop down, there's pre-designated amounts. Some other gift cards may allow you to choose a specific amount and type it out. But for this one, I'm just going to do a $50. Oh, I hit the wrong one. No, I want $50. All right. And again, keep in mind, this is Canadian dollars because I am in Canada, but I like to keep my wallet balance designated in US dollars. So there's going to be some weird discrepancies in terms of the dollar amounts that I'm spending versus what you see in the wallet. But just keep that in mind. Either way, I'd like a 50 Canadian dollar gift card for Amazon. I'm going to hit add to cart. There we go. And then I can either keep shopping or check out. I'm going to check out. All right, at the checkout screen, it gives me the option, hey, you want to pay with Lightning? It gives me some additional information about the order details, btcsessions@gmail.com. That's where the information is going to. Payment method is Lightning. What are you getting? All of that. And there's also an invoice ID. That all looks good to me. So I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to hit pay. Perfect. And now it says order completed. Thank you for your purchase. Down below, I can see my Amazon gift card. And what I can do here is I can hit click to unseal. This will reveal a code that I can then put into my Amazon account and then will credit my account with $50, which I can then use to purchase on anything. Now, the gift cards do vary depending on how you use them. Some of them will be a barcode that you would scan. That's a lot of the gas stations will utilize that method. Others will be redemption codes and things like that. So it really depends on the gift card you're using, but the experience of purchasing them is much the same. And so this is all here. I'm good to go. I can claim this at the time of using it. Alternatively, there is a menu here, and so I can go to my gift cards here, and it will retain this information. But either way, I'm all set. I'm good to go, and I can utilize this right away. I'm going to click to unseal, and I'm going to add that to my Amazon account. And I just wanted to jump over to Amazon and show $50 has been applied successfully to your account. You can check your balance at any time. And there we go. So I've successfully imported that gift card to Amazon. And one final note on the gift cards. When you purchase a gift card through your account on Speed, it will then email details to your email that is associated with your Speed wallet account. And so that's important to note, because if you navigate away from that gift card, that this is how you can get back to it, because there's no, you know, my account or my cards or anything. So if that's important that you be able to navigate back to it and you're not using the full balance or preloading an account or something like that with the gift card, and it's one that you're going to continue to use, just make sure you star that email and keep it. And so, yeah, that's just a hot tip so that you don't lose track of a previous gift card and you're unable to find it. Make sure you star those emails. Now, I want to showcase another cool thing that they've incorporated here, and that's just rewards. That is in the bottom right. If I tap on it, you can see that as you do send Bitcoin from your wallet and you do make purchases and spend and all of that, you earn points. And over time, these points can earn you additional sats. So you can see I'm on the welcome tier right now. Maximize your savings. For every 10, earn a total of 10,000 points and receive 2,500 sats as cash back, which is, again, like the $1 conversion rate depends on the current market price of Bitcoin. Obviously, that'll fluctuate. But nonetheless, you can check the tiers as well. So this is the welcome tier. As you build up, once you earn 10,000 sats, you're moving beyond that. And it says up to 80,000, you can receive 20,000 sats cash back. And you earn more points for every 1,000 sats you spend. And it goes from there all the way up to platinum if you're spending like a madman. So nonetheless, cool little additional feature baked into the wallet.
Now, I also wanted to show that Speed Wallet is compatible with your browser, so you can have access to it from your computer. And the way that you do that is just over on the main website here, speed.app. You're going to need to be in a Chrome browser, but if you look over at the top right, there's something that says Chrome extension. When you click on that, that's going to take you to the Chrome Web Store and give you the option to install this to your browser. Now, mine is already installed, but it'll be exactly where this blue button is. It'll ask you if you'd like to do that, and then it'll just ask for your credentials, however you logged in before, either your Google account, which is probably default, or email and password. And once it's up there, you'll see there's a little Chrome plugin that is set there, and I can click it and it drops down, and lo and behold, there's my wallet. So I can interact with this on the fly here. So I'll just do a couple quick examples here. But again, if I hit receive, well, hey, I can create an invoice if I want to, and I can, you know, let's do say 500 sats, and that will create a Lightning invoice that can be scanned or copied and pasted. And so again, maybe I'll just pull up another wallet that I have here as an example. So I've got a self-custodial wallet here just to show that it'll work. Scan that QR code on the screen. I'll hit pay and off it goes. And I should see here on the screen here, there we go, 500 sats received. So same thing would be true if I were to create an invoice and then copy the invoice down below and paste it into another app. So that will work just fine. And then on the sending side of things, you can also do the same. So if I were to hit send, then I can simply paste in a Lightning address or whatever it may be, or an invoice, or I can drop a QR image there as a picture. So that's super convenient. So I do have another browser plugin here, and this is Albi. So I'm going to create an invoice over here on Albi. Actually, you know what? I'll just use my Albi Lightning address. So here I go. I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to hit send. I'm going to paste in my Get Albi address. I'm going to hit proceed. Then it asks me, well, how much do you want to send? I'll send, let's say... Oh, and then there's an edit button up in the top right, so you can change the amount. So I'll send over 123 sats. That looks good. I can write a note if I want. I'll leave it for now. I'll just hit send, and off it shall go. Okay, so that was sent, and let's double check in Albi. And there we go. There's our 123 sats received. So I'm able to send to and from any regular Lightning address, any regular Lightning invoice, anything that I like directly here, and I can receive as well. And the same applies with the on-chain stuff that we were doing before. You can do it all from the comfort of your browser as a plugin, and the balance and all of your transaction history will be the same across your desktop interface and your phone. It's all the same. There's a final thing that I want to touch on in this video. Now, I won't be going into actually setting it up because I feel it warrants a dedicated video down the line walking through it, but it is using Bitcoin as a merchant with Speed Wallet. And so if you're on their main website, speed.app, there's a section up in the top right that says business. And when you click on that, you're going to be brought to their payment processor page. And with the same credentials that you use for your regular wallet, you can choose to sign in, and that will take you to a merchant account. Now, the merchant account can be, you can play around with it and test out a bunch of things. There's up in the top right, there's something called test mode. So you can walk through and kind of see how to do everything here. And they even have up in the top left a handy get started initial setup guide. And you can just walk through all of these different things. They teach you how to set up the profile, add details, have a custom domain, add payout wallets, all these different things. They also walk you through the different things that you can do, creating payment links, checkout links, single QR codes for businesses, payouts. They've got an affiliate program. You can create invoices, all kinds of stuff through this, and you can track it. You can add customers. You can do all this different stuff through here. So as you can see, it's pretty in depth. You can do a lot with it, but if you're an online merchant or even a brick and mortar merchant and you want to get playing around with this stuff, it seems to be pretty fleshed out. And again, this will be covered in a future video, but I figured I would let you guys know that it's there. And if you want to try out the test mode and start tinkering, then be my guest. And hopefully I'll have another video out on these features soon. So some final thoughts on Speed Wallet here. Again, the name of the game is simplicity. The ability to download an app, use a simple email as your access, and be able to be sending, receiving transactions, both on-chain and Lightning within a few minutes, having a singular balance, not having to figure out which is on-chain and which is Lightning, and just kind of works. Having the ease of use of a Lightning address for anybody to pay you from anywhere. And then also having things like being able to spend your Bitcoin within the same app, maybe being able to purchase gift cards and use it day to day, on top of the rewards program, on top of the merchant stuff, which is very nice, which again, I'll probably cover in a future video, but also having that interoperability between your desktop app in your browser and the exact same interface on your phone. That is kind of the main selling point of Speed Wallet for me, being able to just do all of those things and have it be simple. Now, I will say that there are those of you that are watching the channel that are very, very staunch. I need self-custody, full self-custody with no trade-offs at all times. And if that is you, then maybe this isn't going to be in your wheelhouse of tools that you use day to day. And if that's the case for you, that's totally fine. That's totally personal preference. And you can peruse the channel for tutorials on things that will fit into your exact specifications of what you're looking for when it comes to self-custody. But if you're just maybe as somebody like a Wallet of Satoshi user, where you just wanted something where you could download it and it would just work and you didn't really have to think about it, and it's for day-to-day use, then this might be, I would say, a bit of an upgrade for you, in that you have that simplicity of, okay, I can just log in and it's just there and it just kind of works, and I just use it as my spending wallet. But then you also have that cross compatibility from desktop to your mobile. You have the baked in options for buying gift cards. You have, you know, the reward stuff. You have the Lightning address. You have all the bells and whistles in a simple form. So I think that's kind of what they're going after here. They're going after the Wallet of Satoshi crowd and giving them a meaningful upgrade from what they've been experiencing there. And I think that's totally cool. And I would love to hear your guys' thoughts on it. So if you have thoughts, if you've been playing around with Speed, or just from what you've taken in from this video, hit me with a comment down below. Let me know what you think. And I look forward to hearing from all of you. Thank you guys so much for watching. As always, please do like, subscribe, share, all those things. They help a ton getting this content in front of more eyeballs. If you want to help the show in another way, you can hit up the previously mentioned sponsors in the show notes down below. And I will also add in, if you are sorting through some of the tutorials on the channel and you are finding them helpful, but maybe you need a little bit of extra hand-holding along the way, whether it comes to using a wallet like this, or you're getting into some of the more advanced stuff like hardware, like multisig, like running a node, whatever it may be, feel free to reach out to my team at bitcoinmentor.io. They're happy to lead you through any of your technical Bitcoin questions and get you all set up. They are an awesome group of people that I have aggregated that are just waiting by to help you with anything you may need. So again, reach out at bitcoinmentor.io and they will be waiting for you there. Anyways, with that, I'm going to wrap up. Thank you guys so much for being here, and have yourselves a wonderful day or evening, wherever you may be. I'll see you guys next time for your daily session. HODL the Bitcoin.